Welcome to another episode of Row the Show. We are going to be playing Cincinnati today for a three-game series. Oh, I'm actually leading off. Guess they like my speed. Oh, Shohei Ohtani. Shohei Ohtani's actually on that team, which is unrealistic. I'm going there late April, as well as the other stadiums I haven't been to. All the other stadiums I haven't been to. Washington, Baltimore, both New York stadiums, Boston, Philadelphia. That's it. I'll be 30 stadiums. Also be thrown in Cooperstown, too. Yeah, somebody lied about Shohei Ohtani going to Canada today. He didn't go to Canada. He was in California. The thing is, they raised ticket prices for the Angels Blue Jays game at Angel Stadium in August. Lowest is $42.
Number okay, seven. Go.
And here it comes. Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right, and that will get out of play.
Raise the price gave up on just that pitch early, and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
Laced down the line, base hit right field.
He got it. He's going to stay there. Nice leadoff hits.
And now it's Gavin Lux. On the ground left side,
six, four, three.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third.
To walk.
And they're all loaded
up. Walk
just hasn't had great command of his pitches in this one. Definitely more walks than you'd like to see.
Two outs, bases full. And now here's the Dodgers designated hitter, Gavin Lux.
Let's drop it in.
He hit
there.
Into a double Gavin. Play his first time up. And now the lefty swung on, broken back grounder to third. Scoops it up barehanded to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
From the time you're a
left-hand batter waits. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Now it's Hunter Renfro. One for one. He tripled in his first trip.
Center field appearance.
Renfro.
1-2 now. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Betts makes the grab on the run. One down, base is empty. Slow roller to third. Urshela whips it to first on the run. And that is out number two.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
That was Renfro, right?
We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now the shortstop, Noel V. Marte.
We are leading.
Marte. Nola back to work. This to center field. And there's one away. The pitch. Into center.
He steps to the right.
Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that quickly, two away.
Now back.
Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Now it's the Dodger leadoff hitter, number seven.
I've hit all home runs on the left side.
Let's go right here. Hey, let her fly.
Move to second.
Get him.
Oh, they got him leaning. He's out.
You were sleeping there, huh? Not good. You're not happy.
Hard ground ball, base hits.
Well, a swing like that
probably could have scored
you
from
come out
seconds.
Of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Gavin Lux steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Chopped out in front of the plate.
He got him. He got him.
The throw to first. That's out number three. One hit. And up next for Los Angeles, number seven.
Number three so far.
Let's go. And here we go. You got this.
The wide, the kick, and the 1-2. Base hit, center field.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
And that's ball four.
Nice ball four. Okay.
Not what he wanted to do right there.
On for a while.
That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
So first and second with two outs. Here's Mookie to hit.
He's going to try to pick me off. Like
so now three and two, and that'll load the bases.
Oh, nice.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish.
It's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion, and he's in full speed.
No, of course not.
They take the force out. That's the third out. Over, and now the center fielder, number seven.
Game's still going, huh?
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Oh, they're going to walk me. Oh, two walks this game. We haven't even got done with the game.
So it's second and third occupied. They go for the intentional walk. Base is now loaded. And there's a force at every base.
The batter, number nine.
Next is the Dodger DH, Gavin Lux. The 2-1. Flares it into the outfield. Base hit, and a run comes in. Renfro fires it to the plate. Not in time.
Oh,
he scores. And it's 8-3.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. He didn't connect with one as he met it out front, but he still put a decent enough swing on it to get it into the outfield. You know, and if you finish the swing and just extend your follow-through, you're going to run into Knox just like that.
He's safe.
Stephen Kwan digs in now.
Stephen Kwan.
Right-handed reliever. And that one is lifted in the air. Renfro in position. And he makes the catch. Kicks and fires. And that one lifted in the air center field. Number seven coming on. Nice grab on the run. Two away.
Up next for Cincinnati.
Okay.
Well, a real nice performance out of the pen. This guy is not the one who usually gets the final out, but extended his role a little bit and helped his team get the win. He got the save. Nice job.
8-3 the final in this one. Dave Roberts and company celebrate in the dugout. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi.
8-3 we'll see you soon. Score. 3-for-4, two base on balls.
And here's the rookie center fielder, number seven.
The center fielder, number seven.
The wide to kick the pitch. Clips the corner, and this one is off and running.
Yeah, that's probably the first pitch, and I'm the leadoff batter.
Checks his swing, appeal to third, and he won a round. Rule the swing.
Dang.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
And now it's Gavin Lux. He's 0-1.
We have a chance to drive us in.
He's someone that you might not describe as having elite-level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. 3-2 now. Swing and a ball lifted in the air. Shallow left field. Profar makes the play. And the inning is over.
Going for it all.
Come on, big guy. One time. Here we go.
High fly ball down the left field line.
Go, baby, go.
And that
ball
is out of here.
Goodbye. That's the first home run from my right-hand side.
His seventh home run of the season. It's 4-0.
I think every home run has been from the left-hand side. Got that.
His bat looks like it's in the side zone for such a long time, and that gives him the ability to get barrel on it and hit the ball out to any part of the
seats.
Now it's Hunter Renfro. He struck out swinging in his first at bat. The Reds hitless so far in the game.
Home run number 7.
In the air out to center. Number 7.
All the home runs have been from the left hand side.
Puts the squeeze on that one. One down.
I thought it was on the right hand side because it went towards
runner
left field.
Runner on first with one gone. And ready to hit now for Cincinnati. Mike Yastrzemski. He's 0 for 1. There's a swing and a drive. That one's deep. And it hits the fence. Lead runner holds at third. So two runners in scoring position and just one out.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. You hit the ball so well right there, and I really thought it was going to carry out of here. But that's definitely the big
the
part
wall.
Of the yard, and you just really have to get a hold of one to drive it out in that part of the ballpark. But you can't be mad about driving.
Number 7 steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
Two-run home run in the fourth.
He's already homered in this game. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power.
He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Get some more equipment.
One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
You usually are going to see that inside fastball a little longer coming in from the opposite side, but that pitch really got in on him right there.
Number 7 will hit next. He's already homered here in this one. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they're available to pitchers. It puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that... And a
nice.
Base hit up the middle.
The legs.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Exactly what I'm trying to do.
One gone, runner at first. Next to hit, Gavin Lux.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
Bounce to the right side. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Nice.
Now here is Stephen Kwan. He's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Vogelback over to second, on to first, safe. So they get one, but a really nice try there. And this ball's going to wind up out of play. So a big-time costly mistake there.
That one really hurts. You're already down in the game, and that error puts you even further behind. Just can't let it compound from here, though. You got to flush it, get ready for the next one, make a play, get back in the dugout.
Play, baby. Yep, in the dugout. And on first, with one out.
The 0-1. That's towards center. Number 7 settles underneath it and makes the grab. And there's two away.
The batter, number 6, second baseman.
Okay.
Well, these guys secure a
winning
season with the W today. And regardless of what else happens the rest of the way, you know that you're a winning ball club. So a little bit of pressure off, put your foot on the gas and just see where you can finish from this point on.
And a 7-1 finish in this one.
Okay, one more game. It's been two good games. Put one with a home run.
For 7, he's got the power,
a little bit down the
great
line.
Contact skills. One
probably
of the best contact hitters in the game.
Batting third.
First pitch, just misses. Here's the 2-2. And that one ripped into right. Makes the grab, two down.
Line drive.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it.
Runner on at first with one gone. Gio Urshela to the plate. Nothing here in the bottom of the second. In the the air, pretty deep out to center field. Number 7 under it and puts the squeeze on that one. That's out number 2. Here's a 2-2. That one the other way. And that's a fair ball. Kwan around third. He'll score, and it's 1-0.
Okay.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with 2 strikes. I think he choked up a little bit, maybe spread out, but he got the job done right there.
That's right. On the line.
Here's Mookie now. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. 0-2 now. Hit in the air, right field. Renfroe in position. Brings it in for the third out. 2 outs, nobody on. Here's the shortstop at the plate. Noel V. Marte. And he's already singled in this game. And that one in the air, center field. Makes the grab, and that is that. Number 7 steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 1-for-2. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Lifted in the air, right center field. Renfroe getting an angle on it. Great effort as he's able to haul it in, and that will end the inning. I mean, you're talking about someone that can steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone?
Go get the hits.
Here comes a pitch. Just missed.
Let that one go. I have low attendance at this ballpark. Of course, it's a day game.
Up the middle. Fires to first on the run. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the 8th.
Knew he had to hurry after that nice forehand grab, and he did. He couldn't have transferred the ball from his glove to his hand and released that throw any better than he did right there.
He's in the same zone.
Number 7 getting ready to hit.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
We want what we want.
To the right side.
Fairball.
And it gets by him. Rodriguez around third.
Oh, no.
One run is in. Runner holds at third, so just one across on the play.
Now batting.
Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those
third,
can find a hole and get you a knock.
Yep. Finds the hole. Finding the holes.
Here's Mookie Betts. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads.
On here.
And there's ball 4.
Definitely lost the handle during that sequence. 4 pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
The 0-1. Fly ball to right. He's got it. Runner tags from third. Here's the throw to the plate, but it's offline. And they're up by 4.
In that situation, you're looking to get something up in the zone that you can put in the air. Worst case scenario, a sacrifice fly to drive in that runner from third.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout. So 2 runs in the...
Oh, this is a nice sweep. Good way to finish this series. You're heading to another city for another one.
And the Pittsburgh
maintain the same focus. Whatever you were doing in this city, make sure you're doing the same thing in the next one. Eat the same thing.
Keep it up.
Sleep the same way. Get to the ballpark at the same time.
5-1 is how it ends. And the road team picks up the win and picks up a sweep.
Wonder what place the Cincinnati Reds are in, though. In this game, they have Ohtani though. Hopefully, he's happy with signing with the Reds. He may or may not make the playoffs. I don't think they've made the playoffs in a while. I think the Angels are probably the last. I mean, the longest drought. I have to check that out and see what team has been out of the playoffs for the longest. I think it may be the Angels. They've definitely been out for 10 years. It'll be 10 years. Okay. Anyways, thank you for watching. It's a great game. Looking forward to the next one. Like this video, share this video, and subscribe so you see future videos. And I'll see you in the next film one. Have a great day.